This video is brought to you by Envato Elements. Today, we'll learn how to apply the tilt shift effect to your video in Final Cut Pro. This is a fun effect that causes the focal point of your video to appear like a miniature scale model. Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge, and welcome back to my channel. Today, we'll learn how to use Final Cut Pro to fake the tilt shift effect traditionally achieved by using a special lens. The tilt shift effect originates in photography. By changing the location of the camera lens in relation to the camera sensor, you're able to give the viewer a unique perspective on the scene being photographed. One unintended side effect of tilt shift photography is a unique focus area in the frame, where the depth of focus is very narrow, but can extend out to infinity. This makes a real-world scene appear like a miniature scale model of that scene. And even though this was unintentional, miniaturizing real-world scenes is now synonymous with tilt shift photography. This translates very well to video. So what we're going to do today is take a few scenes and turn them into miniatures with a tilt shift effect. To get the best results, you need a shot taken from above the scene with a camera pointed down at about 20 to 30 degrees. This reflects the point of view someone taking a video of a miniature scene would likely have. The video must be sharp and have infinite focus. Drone shots work awesome for this. There are a couple ways of adding this effect in Final Cut Pro. The first method is by blurring your entire scene and selecting a focal point with a shape mask. Select your clip in the timeline and make a copy of it by holding down the Option key and dragging straight up. With the top clip selected, open the effects browser and from the blurs category, add the Gaussian blur effect to your top clip. Bring the amount down to about 25%. Next, select the masks category and add a shape mask to your top clip. Up in the inspector, select the invert mask checkbox to invert your mask. Use the on-screen mask controls to simulate the depth of field of a tilt shift lens. Drag in on either the top or the bottom handle to make it narrow, and use one of the side handles to extend it all the way out. Reposition your mask so the focal point is close to the middle and drag out on the feather ring to soften the transition. This is all you have to do. This is a shot we started with. And here's the same shot with a tilt shift effect applied to it. Before we take a look at the second method, I want to take a minute to talk about the sponsor of this video, Envato Elements. Envato Elements is an all-in-one subscription service with millions of digital assets for all types of creators, especially filmmakers. Whether you need some extra B-roll for your project, a background music track for your travel video, cool graphics or animations, or one-of-a-kind title for your intro, Envato Elements has it. And everything they have to offer is included for one low monthly fee. With unlimited downloads and new assets added every week, it just keeps getting better and better. I've been using Envato Elements for a few years now, and every single one of my videos includes something I downloaded from Envato. For example, in this video, both my demo clips, the music you hear in the background, and even my intro animations were all downloaded from Envato Elements. By subscribing to Envato Elements, not only will you improve your videos, but you also support this channel for more free tutorials like this one. Now, back to Final Cut Pro. The second method of adding a tilt shift effect to your video is by using the focus blur effect. This method is even easier than the first one, but it doesn't give you quite as much control. Regardless, when used on the right clip, you can still achieve excellent results. Go back to the effects browser, and from the blurs category, add the focus blur effect to your clip. Use the on-screen controls to place the center of this effect over your focal point, and head over to the video inspector. First, drag the width slider all the way up to extend the area in focus as wide as possible, and adjust the height slider to bring more or less of your frame into focus. You can also play around with the softness slider to make your transition less noticeable. This is a clip we started with. And once again, here's the same clip with a tilt shift effect. If you enjoyed this video, let me know by hitting the like button or in the comments below. And make sure to check out Envato Elements. For every one of you that subscribes, I get a small percentage of it. So thank you for supporting my channel. Thanks for watching. I'll see you back here next week.